back in that 6-2 that they've had so much success with to start the season. Moved away from that, went to the 5-1 over the last three because of those injuries. Nebraska's Lindsey Krause still out as we're underway in Lincoln. Three ball over. Riley goes behind her to Beeson, the tip. Another free ball opportunity here for Nebraska. Riley to Beeson again. That time the swing up by Rodriguez, but the kill on that left side of the swing goes to, I believe that was Timmy Thomas-Ilara with the kill.
Bit of a chaotic start for both teams. Saw a few free balls go over the way. This is one of those matchups where your adrenaline is pumping. There's so much energy and anticipation. So expect both teams to be a little shaky to start. Maybe a few balls go out just with that adrenaline at full height.
Good to Ken, back to serve now for the Badgers. Right back this time, that's Harper Murray. Good up, Franklin to keep it alive. Finally terminates on a free ball. Nebraska had several opportunities.
This is where Nebraska is great. When they get free balls like that, they always put them right on the money. This Nebraska offense, so unpredictable in that sense. And when you have a player like Becca Alec who dominates that front line, that's point Huskers.
Harper Murray. One-handed set, knocked down by Booth from off the net. Roll shot over, knocked down by Robinson. And then Booth puts it down in the overpass.
This is what Nebraska needs to avoid, that net play, because Wisconsin is so physical up front. With a player like Carter Booth, she stands at 6'7". You can't go up against her on a joust. She's going to go right up and over you every time. Nebraska has to control those passes, keep them off the net about a foot.
Here's the jump serve of Yulia Ojol. Good pass there from Murray in system. A little tight for Batenhorst on the net. Ben Robinson with no touch. The swing is long. Point 2-2. Head coach for Nebraska, John Cook, in his 24th season. Former coach at Wisconsin. Pete Waite followed him. And then Kelly Sheffield has led the Badgers to new heights over the last 10 years. Was there for Nebraska. And then Franklin just sends that over right at Beeson for the point.
Franklin barely even jumped at that ball. Just a quick, easy down ball. Those are plays Nebraska has to continue to convert, especially when Franklin is throwing in roll shots, something she does pretty well. They have to be ready at all times to move side to side.
There is Sarah Franklin, Michigan State transfer. MJ Hamill to serve. She will be setting out of the back row for the Badgers. And the middle, and Andy Jackson, the dynamic freshman.
Andy Jackson with a little bit of heat up front. Beautiful pass makes this offense unpredictable, and they know they can go to their middles on a perfect pass, and it'll be one-on-one almost every single time. Beautiful swing right through the seam of the block.
Didn't look there like Wisconsin was cheating on the middle either. They're going to react and read. Smrek with the swing there. Goes off of Smrek, not down. On the back row, was there a touch? No touch call, point Wisconsin.
Watch for Nebraska to continue to get that back row attack going. They know that in these rotations, when they have either Harper Murray or Merritt Beeson in the back row, they have to continue to establish them as a threat and try to pull in those blockers.
Timmy Thomas-Ilara back in. Sure. Run the left side, and here is where Anna Spreck moves to the right. Out of the back row, that's Beeson found the open floor.
Beautiful swing for Merritt Beeson in the back row. Wisconsin leaving a seam in that block. A veteran player like Beeson is able to go right through it on this play. Wisconsin's reading on their block, so they're late to this call, leaving that seam in the block for Beeson to hit through.
Timmy Thomas-Ilara off the top of the block. Outside Murray. Great up by Orzol. point, Nebraska.
But Orgel making an incredible play, diving into that seam, keeping this ball alive. But it's a free ball that goes over and lands in on Wisconsin's side. Just a miscommunication.
Pushed outside. And rolled right short of the net. And Nebraska up by two. There is the head coach of the Badgers in his 11th season, Kelly Sheffield, five-time Big Ten champs, including four consecutive, and of course that national title win in 2021 over these Nebraska Cornhuskers. Upset. Not down. Back row, Beeson. Swept out the hand on it, but sent it wide.
Nebraska right out of the gates. This transition defense has been huge. They're getting touches on players like Anna Smrek. They have to continue to do that to convert offensively.
Good service run here by Lainey Choboy, the freshman DS for Nebraska. And Choboy kept it up. Fires on the Badgers side.
Plays like that, going against one of the best blocking teams in the country. She is so strong. Watch how hard she pushes that ball over. No one's beating Burton Riley on that.
Saw Riley do that a couple of times against middle blockers last week, right? Really strong at the net.
Even one-handed, she'll beat them.
Tough serve there. Timmy Thomas Ilara again. The swing is wide. Did they get a touch? No touch. Point Nebraska. And right away, the bench for the players for Wisconsin turning to the bench and telling Kelly Sheffield, that was definitely a touch, and Sheffield's gonna reach for the card. So a quick challenge here early on at 9-4.
Wisconsin is challenging that there was a touch on the play.
Temi Thomas-Ilara trying to go for those high hands. The ball hit a little bit flat, definitely going for fingertips. Let's see if there actually was a touch on it.
Hmm.
That angle looks clear inside.
Oh, maybe watch Murray's hands. After it clears the net, watch the hands of Murray right here. Hard to tell there, but on that super slow-mo play that we had on this one right here, the hands.
On the left side of your screen, she's putting her hands up right now.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yep.
To the touch, not at the net, but right there. This, likely based on that, will be overturned and point for the Badgers.
That was something Nebraska talked about in serve and pass today, about how sharp Wisconsin's outsides will hit, whether it's Sarah Franklin or Temi Thomas-Ilara. Those off blockers have to be always ready for that sharp cross shot, because they'll hit it often.
You think about the growth of volleyball, Emily, over the last few years, and these two programs so responsible for that growth, the programs, the coaches, the fans, and what they've given back to the sport and allowed it to grow. It's remarkable.
These are two head coaches who are doing so much for the sport. You think of a coach like Kelly Sheffield, just with us even, in terms of access, letting us come to practices, film sessions, willing to push the envelope, moving the game last year to the Kohl Center to play Florida. Then you think of John Cook for Nebraska, playing in Memorial Stadium, getting so many eyeballs, breaking that women's sports attendance record. It's really impressive what both John Cook and Kelly Sheffield have done, not just for their programs, but for the sport as a whole.
Maybe a bit longer than we thought, given that look right there. But again, they're looking at multiple angles. And hopefully not just looking at the touch of the net, right? Because that's obviously the tendency would be to look at the net touch. And
that's where I looked at first.
Yeah, that's right.
This is a game where, yes, it might be only 4-9 pretty early on. Challenges can be really important down the line. As these two teams, you look at them historically, a lot of sets over the last five or so years, only won by 2 points. So a challenge could be the difference of winning a set or not, which could be winning the match or not.
think about, you know, the Nebraska momentum. They had five consecutive. And this is a long replay, and I think we have a decision now. This is our R2. So this would be our R2, Nathan Wagner, and Nebraska. Clearly just did not see the touch of Harper Murray because it was fairly obvious from our point of view. So it does stand, Nebraska on top by five now, 9-4. Good pass by Franklin, they run the middle, touch by Smart, not down. Swiping it off the block, is it out? No, it's down, the block by Wisconsin.
Huge up, Laney Choboy in the back row. This is why Nebraska is so great. They basically have two liberos playing back there that can make jaw-dropping plays like that. But if you send an out-of-system ball going outside, Hannah Spreck's going to shut you down every time. 6'9", just towers over everyone.
On the slide, Jackson, a little off time with her setter. Riley pushes outside to Murray. Free ball opportunity here for Nebraska. Back row, Beeson. Wide. Point for the Badgers.
Right out of the gates, you can tell with Carter Booth and Anna Sprint going up on a back row attack, Merritt Beeson has to funnel that ball to left back, just missing a little bit wide, not turning that thumb in.
For blocking out, tools the hands of Sprint.
Because Harper Murray is so fast to get on top of this ball, oftentimes she will two blockers in that way, even if they are a lot bigger than her. If that block doesn't get up fast enough, she's able to find those hands and send it right out.
Into the match now for Nebraska, Kennedy Orr to serve. Orr, the number one ranked setter in her class coming out, had knee injuries, and she's now in a serving specialist role and has accepted that role here for the Huskers. The top of the block goes Smrek, not down. Here is Murray. Back row, Franklin. Back row attack. She was on the line when she attacked. And right now, Badgers hitting negative.
Wisconsin having difficulty getting the ball in the court. Also throwing in a lot of roll shots, something we don't normally see from this Wisconsin team that relies on that physicality and power up front.
Serve there right along the sideline, but not a tough swing for Timmy Thomas. Ilara, boy, she has some power.
How about Sarah Franklin? An amazing pass diving into that seam. She wants to take the ball away from Timmy Thomas Ilara so she doesn't have to pass. Gets a perfect pass that allows the outside to go with tempo. That little seam in the block, Thomas Ilara bangs it right through.
A combo there as well with Booth running and opening up that slight lane for TT to kill. 11-7 here early on. Once again, just a little push off of the block by Harper Murray.
Harper Murray is doing a fantastic job of really switching up those shots. She's not just all power cross court down the line. She's using the hands well. She's throwing in good off speeds as well to confuse the defense on the other side.
8,300 plus inside the Devaney Center. First service error of the match. It's something we certainly will keep an eye on.
Nebraska struggling with serves over the last few weeks, missing a lot more than they did at the beginning of the season. But against Big Ten teams, you gotta serve just a little bit tougher because of how good this conference is. You gotta find a way to get your opponents out of system. Sometimes that'll cause errors to happen as well.
Beach Dickin with the serve. In the middle. Into the net called on Nebraska, point for the Badgers.
Nebraska getting just a little bit too aggressive up front on this block. In volleyball, if any part of your hand, shirt, body touches that net on a block move and comes down, that's automatic point for the other side.
pass by Cho Boy in system. Set not great out to Beeson, who managed to reach behind her to keep that alive.
Merritt Beeson bettered that ball. Wasn't a beautiful set. The timing was a little bit off with her on the outside, but she switched up her arm swing, knew she had to send that roll shot over, did a great job adjusting.
Harper Murray at the service line.
The service long point, Wisconsin. Back serving for the Badgers, number 22, Julia.
Just two here early, but it certainly has been an Achilles heel for this Husker team.
In practice, John Cook says they're doing a great job of serving, just not translating that to matches.
Just long as both Huskers turned and watched it go by the inline.
Typically for Wisconsin, they're a team that relies on that serve. They're doing a phenomenal job leading the Big Ten during conference play in aces per set. But against this Nebraska team, they're in system at such a high clip. You got to put a little bit extra on it, so you're okay with those errors.
Hit the block, and there's Deb Robinson with the kill.
Robinson tallying up her first kill of the night. So great to have her back in this lineup for Wisconsin. She missed the last three matches with the left shoulder injury. Having her back, along with MJ Hamill, is back to the consistency that we've seen from Wisconsin all season long.
MJ Hamill back in to serve. House with the kill, and Batenhorst gives the Huskers the 15.
They're both always cracking jokes. Probably a dad joke. They're both good at that.
Sarah Franklin tried line. There was no touch, no point. And Coach Sheffield asking once again, as they're calling for a challenge. He's lost one and shouldn't have lost that one, and now he's going to go for his second challenge here early in set number one. This is dicey, Emily. This is dicey.
This is a massive risk. We're still in set one, barely even halfway through. Already using that second challenge and on a touch call. Those are the hardest things to challenge. Normally those are what take a while because sometimes you don't have the best looks at it. They have to be completely certain there was a touch.
Certainly looked like it there.
Certainly looked like Bergen Riley, two and white, touched that ball with the right hand. See if the refs see it.
Ever so slightly, but does look like a touch on Bergen.
And from here on out for Wisconsin, even if they do keep this challenge, from here on out, they have to be so confident if there was a major touch call on these balls, because he has to continue to keep those challenges. He can't lose one.
And it was a touch. So they reverse Kelly with the sigh there.
Massive sigh of relief.
Okay, I still have a challenge left.
And that shows you how much he trusts a player like Sarah Franklin. He said, hey, are you 100% positive?
Number 13, Sarah Franklin.
So Sarah Franklin now back to serve for Wisconsin. A big piece of foreshadowing by the conference. Sarah Franklin, the player of the week. Lexi Rodriguez, defensive player of the week, is Batenhorst from that left pin with another kill. She needed to have a big night coming in.
A big storyline for Nebraska is not having Lindsey Krause in this game. She rolled her ankle before their game against Northwestern on Wednesday, now in a boot and crutches on the sideline. Allie Batenhorst stepped back into the lineup. We saw her early on in the season, so she's used to being in it, but she has to play a big factor tonight.
Touched the tip of the net by Crawford, not down. That's a freshman. Harper Murray, top-ranked outside hitter in the country.
Murray just a freshman, but she makes such massively high volleyball IQ plays. She knows that middle blocker's way bigger than her, so watch what she does. She goes for CeCe Crawford, the shorter of the two, and goes right over it.
Top at the field house in Madison. There is Lainey Choboy to serve. Third service error for Nebraska to one. for the Badgers.
At the line serving for the Badgers, number 9, CeCe Crawford.
Back to serve, CeCe Crawford.
This is one of Wisconsin's better rotations with Carter Booth and Anna Smart up front.
Randy Jackson on the slide, no doubt, as Booth hung just a little bit in the middle.
Smart decision for Bergen Riley. She has to run Andy Jackson on that side as much as possible. Keep it away from Booth and Smrek because it's a much shorter blocker for Wisconsin's outside when you have Temi Thomas-Ilara going up against a good slide attacker like Jackson.
Both teams very balanced right now in kills. Nebraska with 6 players with kills. Wisconsin has 5. A quick middle and no doubt there by Carter Booth. What a tremendous addition she has been to this Badger squad.
Carter Booth has been one of the difference makers for this Wisconsin team. With the departure of Danielle Hart, they needed this piece to step in, not only offensively, but defensively. And here, doing a fantastic job. She's always off the net. Good space from her setter to have that full lane and momentum into her attack.
Overpass. Deb Robinson put it down.
Nebraska has to control those passes just a little bit.
In terms of percentage. And here is the always difficult serve of Izzy Ashburn. Second touch. That's a set over.
Sneaky, sneaky set from Bergen Riley. This ball up to the top of the tape. It looks like she's going to set this slide attack at the last second. Just drops that right shoulder to send it to the campfire of the court. Massive hole on Wisconsin's side.
Now back to serve. Good up by Riley. Overpass. There's Rodriguez. Rodriguez again. Here is Beeson. Good opportunity here. Ashburn pushes it out. Timmy Thomas-Ilara off the block and down. Big win there for the Badgers.
More Nebraska defense getting these balls up, and we're seeing it on both sides now. Just insane hustle plays. That one from Riley. This is what makes it so difficult. It's tough to put a ball down against them. And though Wisconsin got this transition play, got a touch off of that block, it was more of a miscommunication on Nebraska's side that let that ball fall.
Inside the block goes Harper Murray.
Against this physical Wisconsin team, Nebraska's doing a phenomenal job going around the block or using the edges of it. They're not hitting right down into it, which is what they scouted for. They knew they had a big block in front of them, so they have to go for the edges.
Nebraska the first to 20 here in set one. Franklin off of the block. Rodriguez comes in to take the set. Beeson off the top of it. And Merrick Beeson with another kill. She has 4.
How about that set from Lexi Rodriguez coming running in this play, so aware of where she is on the court. She has to take this off of 1 foot. She's jumping and setting it. Beautiful hand. She looks like a setter out there.
In the nation.
It's the best in the nation. Also, Kelly mentioned it, but the fans so invested in the sport really all around. And now that those middle of the team Big Ten teams are getting better as Wisconsin puts that one down, it's really elevating the conference as a whole because those maybe more so bottom of the pack teams or middle of the pack teams, they're testing the Wisconsin and Nebraskas every single year.
Third kill for Devin Robinson on 6 swings. She's hitting 333 with just 1 attack error. Lift carry, little carry there in the hands for Nebraska's Becca Alec.
This has happened a few times over the last few weeks. Sometimes Alec gets a little too aggressive with that ball. If it's in her hand for too long while she's throwing it, they'll get called for that.
Back-to-back points for the Badgers. Back now to within 3. And Rojal into the net. Second service error on Wisconsin. That's a big swing by Franklin. It was behind her, but found a way to get to it.
Big swing, that's exactly what Wisconsin needed. They have to claw their way out of the hole now. A player like Franklin is someone they rely on in these moments. She's taking the big swings at the big times. Even with two big blockers in front of her, she has the confidence to take those big swings.
Checking in to serve for the Badgers, number six, MJ Hamill.
So Hamill back in now to serve, and she will set.
And notice Izzy Ashburn still in the front row. She'll play on that right side. So watch for Nebraska to set the outside. They like that blocking matchup.
Did not clear the tape and the hitting error on Andy Jackson.
And Hamill back to the service line again. This is what happens when you run a 6-2. Sometimes you get late in sets. That sub count, you come really close to pretty quickly.
Crowd trying to get into this. Badgers back to within two. Baitenhorst with the kill.
Baitenhorst knew the scouting report. With Izzy Ashburn up front, a shorter setter for Wisconsin, she's going to attack that line as often as she can if that set's there. This ball all the way out to the pin. She's going right over 11 in red.
Tough serve by Beeson. There's Sarah Franklin. Bump set to Baitenhorst. Set point. Get the touch. Second set point upcoming for Nebraska. Sarah Franklin goes to the back row to serve. And John Cook is going to take his second timeout as the Badgers rattle off two more. Nebraska will have its third set point.
Nine opponents, rather.
Third set point. Of a horse and the loyalty of horses and what you have to do to live in a, be in a pack, right?
Whatever you got to do to win, you'll take it.
It works.
Giddy up, John Cook.
Beeson fires right off the block. Devin Robinson with the block falls to the middle of the floor.
Wisconsin needs a little bit more of that this set. They didn't do a good job getting those block touches or really stuffs even. Normally so physical up front, they have to get their hands over a little bit quicker from here on out.
In the block again.
Another big one from D-Rob up front, making her presence known right away. Getting Nebraska a little bit out of system, off the net. Devin Robinson read it beautifully, diving those hands back into the seam.
Well, great job defensively, but Devin Robinson couldn't get it back over. Good reaction, though, by Franklin to keep that alive.
Huge pickup from Sarah Franklin, just keeping that ball up, whatever means necessary. Doesn't always have to be your platform. You throw a shoulder in there, a foot. She's just ready to go. Julia Orgel, how about that reaction time, just throwing a platform out.
Timmy Tomasolara again. Second time Harper Murray gets it up. Two touches called on Nebraska.
That ball just coming a little bit wonky out of Bergen Riley's hands. Not a player that you often see have those double calls, but sometimes when you're on the move, you're a little bit sweaty, sometimes it comes out a little funky.
Job by Devin Robinson to keep that up. Batenhorst.
Allie Batenhorst coming alive as this game has gone on. We saw in that end of the first set coming alive. Wisconsin really leveling up their defense. Izzy Ashburn getting under that one along with Robinson to pop it up. Allie Batenhorst is able to finish it off, going right between the seam and the block.
Five kills for Batenhorst, one error, 11 swings. She's hitting 364. Two touches called on the Badgers. Come off the net. Team's out of system here in this rally. Still, here's Devin Robinson. Into the block. Allie Batenhorst.
Such a disciplined block from Nebraska up front. They know out of system. They knew exactly who was getting this ball with Gooch-Tekin setting Robinson on the right side. That block had time to set up. They worked well together and went up to get those hands really pressed.
Good up. Franklin from off, and drops right in the middle. Sarah Franklin.
Just jaw-dropping defensive plays on both sides, Larry. We're seeing it on either side. Harper Murray looking like a libero back there getting this ball up. Wisconsin side as well. Gigi, beautiful dig. Sarah Franklin sends it right to the campfire. Nebraska's off blocker has to pick those up.
Free ball. Good opportunity here for the Badgers. Robinson. Got it. Killed by Devin Robinson.
In system, Wisconsin's offense is so difficult to stop because of how many weapons they have. They always have three hitters up front in this 6-2 offense. So you can send it to either pin. It's oftentimes one-on-one with the free ball.
One-on-one, into the net, called on Franklin.
Franklin getting a little bit too aggressive on that play. Did well, though, to be in position and get that block touch. Hands just came right down on the net afterwards.
Good pass by Franklin, calls for it right back. And delivers. Great cross court by Franklin.
Beautiful cross court. That's the shot we've been waiting for Sarah Franklin to hit. Doesn't feel like we've seen her unload on a ball yet. That was the first one. That's her bread and butter shot. Going cross court, turning that thumb down, going real sharp.
MJ Hamill back in. Was out over the last few matches. This her first back. the slide. Jackson right into the block of Sarah Franklin.
Huge shutdown from Sarah Franklin. She mirrored this slide attack so well, meaning she was making the exact same movements as the middle. Watch her release, go up, and then drop her hands back inside the tape.
Back to her. Franklin got the hands on it again. Bump set out to Sarah Franklin. Batenhorst. Good up by Olzel on the back. And then the block, Spreck. Out of the timeout from Nebraska, 8-5 Wisconsin here in set number two. Huskers took the first, and they go right back to Allie Batenhorst. And inside the block goes Batenhorst, avoids Smrek, and gets the kill.
Batenhorst has been the X factor tonight for Nebraska. It was a question of how she would do stepping into this role in one of the biggest games. What she's shown is she's leveling up her play.
By Franklin, put up by Murray from behind, and Franklin puts it right back. Check that, Smrek puts it right back down.
Hey, you give Anna Smrek an overpass at 6'9". She's probably gonna have the advantage there. This ball, she's so ready at all times to kill it on an overpass. I mean, she barely even has to jump to get her arm over that. But she puts even more power on it.
Just the second kill for Anna Smrek here. Tried and line, good dig by Hamill. Timmy Thomas Ilara will just send it over. The tip to Murray. You'd like to see a lot more faster paced offense out of a free ball like that, right?
Yeah, you would like to see faster paced offense, but hey, whatever it takes to get it done, a kill is a kill at the end of the day.
It's the coaching you right there. Whatever it takes.
Point is a point, could be ugly, doesn't matter. All looks the same on the box score.
Here's Kennedy Orr now to serve. Overpass. And the block. Crawford with that block.
Crawford with such a dynamic move up front. She knew her middle and a strike wasn't going to close. So what she did, watch her dive her hands back into the seam. Nine in red. She takes them back to the left, knowing that middle isn't there to get the stuff.
Now Crawford back to serve. On top 10-7. Smrek again, blocks Murray.
Nebraska's offense is becoming too predictable. They're sending every ball outside. When you have a blocker like Anna Smrek up front, you gotta find a way to spread it out just a little bit. Get that middle involved and relieve the pressure on your outside attackers.
Wisconsin defense, you can see, one of the top in the league as well. On the slide.
Much better job from Nebraska spreading out that offense. Becca Alec looking so explosive, identifying that cross-court shot and letting everything out on this ball. A lot of space for her to hit on the left side of the court. She hits that beautifully.
Beeson one-on-one. And that one's won by Timmy Thomas Ilara.
All right then, Tammy, get those hands over. Wisconsin doing a much better job this set, not only getting those stuff blocks, but really getting a lot of touches as well in this transition play. It was tough. She was one-on-one, dove those hands back into the seam where she knew her middle wasn't to get that ball.
Pulled GT inside there. Beeson also got pulled inside. Back to Beeson again. And that falls for a point for the Badgers.
Wisconsin's eighth block of just this set alone. They're completely owning the tape up front. Every ball Nebraska is setting, it's right into the hands of Wisconsin. They're putting it down.
Largest lead of the match for the Badgers at 5-13-8. Great up. Lizzie Ashburn keeping that alive. They'll go right back to Alec again.
Much smarter decision for Nebraska. They got to get the middles going as much as possible. It relieves pressure on some of those pin attackers. And when you have a player like Becca Alec, she's your momentum kid, your energy kid. You get her the ball, that gives your entire team energy.
Badgers hitting 188 here in the set to Nebraska's negative 033. The top of the block and another kill by Timmy Thomas-Ilara. She's coming alive now.
Thomas-Ilara coming alive, also mixing up her shots really well. We've seen her bang some balls right into the seam. A lot of off speeds from her tonight. That time being smart, going right at the fingertips.
Third kill, three hitting errors. She's hitting right at zero now. But her last few beginning to get into a rhythm. Gutschicken. Back-to-back digs by Uchtigan. And then off the block. That went off of, I believe it went off of a Badger. Was that off of, it was off of Sarah, right? Sarah Franklin?
I think Franklin tried to play that off a little bit. Looks like she got blocked right back in her head.
So off of Nebraska's block, off of Franklin's head and out. Franklin again got on top of that one. Says, yeah.
No question about that ball. Franklin putting everything in her power behind it. This is what makes her so great. If you give her even that little bit of a seam to attack, her vision is so great. She sees it and rips it.
Nearly six kills per set last week in being named Big Ten Player of the Week. And the block on the right side. Crawford right now. Badgers owning set number two.
Badgers owning the block and really owning Nebraska's left sides. The Huskers have to spread out this offense just a little bit better. Either get Harper Murray going out of the back row or send this ball back to Beeson.
11 blocks now for the Badgers to 4 for Nebraska. Badger block has just been stifling, and then it forces swings like that.
That's what a block does. When you've been so dominant over the last few plays, it forces hitters to think about just a little bit more and trying to hit shots that they don't necessarily want to hit.
80 around the top of the bowl. And oh, by the way, it's going to be a hot ticket as well when they play in Wisconsin. Those tickets are already 250 GA to get in.
Robbing us.
Devin Robinson, block touch there by Batenhorst. The tip thrown right back. Crawford just stares down Beeson after throwing it down.
Make it 10 for Wisconsin this set. Nebraska has to adjust to some of these blocks. Go up and over it. They know it's going to be a tall block in front of them. Send this ball just a little bit higher. Aim for the edges. Swing flat. Swing high. Do something different. You can't allow a team to get 10 blocks against you just through a little bit more than halfway through the set.
Maggie Mendelson checks in for Nebraska. Checks in for Merritt Beeson. It's an imposing front row there for the Badgers. Rosal with the serve. Jackson off the block. Here's Batenhorst. Tried line, no touch. Point for Wisconsin. And the Badgers are rolling here in set two.
That's what a tough block does. It forces a player like Allie Batenhorst to hit shots that she doesn't want to hit. When you have a disciplined block in front of you, you're testing edges. Sometimes they'll go long.
Batenhorst again. And Batenhorst off the overpass.
Nebraska getting some much-needed momentum, forcing that overpass. No blocker up against Allie Batenhorst. She better put that ball straight down.
Beeson right back in now to serve. 19-11 lead for Wisconsin. Robinson, long, no touch. No, there was a touch.
Killed by number 10, Devin Robinson.
You see Nebraska right away. All the players turned to John Cook and said there was no touch. And Cook is going to challenge.
Nebraska is challenging that there was no touch.
Didn't seem like Robinson even thought there was a touch on that ball coming down. We'll see. Ball definitely came off a little bit funky off of Robinson's hands. That's clear inside, Allie Batenhorst.
Mm-hmm.
If you'll notice, her arm a little bit bent while she's hitting the ball. That set just a little bit too low, so she's not at full extension. She can't snap down on it. It's forcing the trajectory up, causing this ball to go straight out of bounds.
Net cam right there might be the best look. Didn't see any fingers move, and from this angle you see it's outside. So we already have our call.
A quick one.
And it was out. No touch. Point Nebraska. Beeson now back to serve. 19-12. Off the tape. Into the block. Crawford again.
Tally them up, Larry. We got 11 so far just this set from Wisconsin. They're doing a great job getting Nebraska out of system. What that forces is a ball where they know exactly where it's going on the outside. They have time to set up, and it's an absolute wall in front of the Huskers.
You see the blocks, 13-4. Advantage Badgers. Back row. That big block was up there, two blockers up there on the Bick. And Beeson swing well high. And Merritt Beeson right now hitting negative. 5 kills, 8 errors, 20 swings for Merritt Beeson. Largest lead of the match for the Badgers at 21-12. Jackson on the slide goes off the hands of Sarah Franklin.
The Huskers need a little bit more of that, spreading out this offense, getting their middles involved in the play. This is one of the attacks that Nebraska has to get going more often, on the slide, and you can beat blockers inside, and with the power that Andy Jackson brings, that'll be big for the Huskers if they can continue to get that going.
Hayden Kubik now into the game for the Huskers. Franklin with another kill. That is 7 now. She's hitting above 225.
Franklin just going right at the hands of the block. She knew there'd be two in front of her, so she tested the edges, swung hard, and swung high.
Jackson on the slide, turns the block of Timmy Thomas-Ilara and gets a kill.
Anytime Nebraska's in system, they gotta find their middle attackers. That time getting Jackson on the slide, switching up her shot wonderfully. Last time going in the seam, this time going high hands down the line.
Very quiet in here when Nebraska serves.
Pinned up.
Misconnection there with Smrek. Swing is wide. Point Wisconsin by Kubik.
Kubik just trying to avoid the big block that's in front of her with Anna Smrek up there. You have to hit just a little bit higher and harder if you want to get it past. That's resulting in errors. So while the block isn't getting stuffed, they're doing their job.
Good coverage there by Riley. Kubik again into another block for the Badgers. And there's some glaring going on across the net after those hit the floor.
Nothing gets your team hyped up more than a block. This set gives Wisconsin so much momentum putting 12 up.
Set point here for the Badgers. There's Kubik into the block. Net violation called on Wisconsin. This is just the fifth match in which Hayden Kubik has seen action this year. He was in for a set against Penn State. Kubik's had a couple of swings here in the second set. Still looking for a first kill. And the ace.
When you're down this much in a set, sometimes maybe you can't come back in it, but what you can do is really build that momentum. String together just a few more points to take in to the next one.
Third set point upcoming. Punched over by Kubik. And the middle, Booth is blocked. Here's Spreck. One-on-one, Beeson. Beeson with the tip, gets the kill.
Lexi Rodriguez turning defense into offense for her team. Incredible read. This ball tipped right off the block. She's able to chase it down, not only get it up, but to get a good transition for them to run.
Another opportunity here for the Badgers to close out the set. Serve long point, Badgers, and set the Badgers. And a five-time conference championship coach. Service errors did not creep up to bite Nebraska in set two, but the Wisconsin block certainly did.
And Nebraska could even serve a little bit harder. I think during set two, they lacked a little bit of that aggression from the service line. They got to drive this Wisconsin team back to try to get them out of system.
So when you give up, you know, 12 blocks in a set, what kind of adjustments are you making?
Well, you got to swing high. You have to swing high, go for the edges of the block, and put your hitters in a better position to do so. Keep them off the net. Perfect example of that. This out-of-system set, everyone knew where the ball was going, but it was far enough off of the net that she had space to hit. She had a lane to hit rather than just going down right into the big block in front of her. She can go around it.
Served by Harper Murray. Devin Robinson. Dug by Riley, bump set to Batenhorst. As he goes behind her, and Dev Robinson delivers.
Nebraska's made it a point to block Devin Robinson's line. That means what she's gonna do is switch up her shots more, go to that cross court where we saw the one before, and then that one right into the seam of the blockers if the middle doesn't close.
Off the top of the block. Robinson not down. Out of system, the bump set to Franklin. The angle, and Franklin delivered.
Sarah Franklin is one of the best out of system attackers in the entire conference. Even when she can't see the block in front of her, she knows where they're set up and she knows what shot to hit, whether she has to bring speed, bring power, or use that off speed and place it.
Just love how she slows her feet, resets, gets those feet in great position.
Great step close.
Yep. Ojal's serve is long.
Back serving for your Husker number 8, Lexi Rodriguez.
Rodriguez now back to serve. Andy Jackson in for the Huskers. Out assist him. The bump set for Beeson. Went high hands, and that time tooled the block of Crawford in a rare kill off of Crawford for Nebraska.
Smart shot from Beeson. Beeson going right inside the blocker's hands. They're well set up in front of her because it's out of system. She sees they're really far taking that line. That allows a lot of cross-court space for her to swing at.
Robinson swipes that straight down. And they're going to say the kill. And Chad Cook wants to know why that is in the lift.
We saw Becca Alec get called on that throw earlier in the set. That one looked like it was in Robinson's hands a little too long, but it's completely subjective. You can't challenge it. You see this ball, Robinson in her hand for a decent amount of time before it gets out.
No touch there. Point for the Badgers. Another hitting error on Nebraska. Huskers hitting negative once again and all the way down to 050 for the match.
Another hitting error for Nebraska, but it's because Wisconsin's block has been so disciplined. They're forced to hit shots they don't want to hit, trying to go around it. Beeson tries to sneak it down the line, but goes out of bounds.
Good decision by Bergen Riley.
Good things happen when your team's in system. That allows the pins to run with a little bit more speed, which has holes in the block because the middle is held with their other middle a little bit late to that. A lot of seams for her to hit.
Sarah Franklin now back to serve. Badgers on top by two here in set three. We're all knotted at a set apiece, but you feel like the momentum right now heavily weighted in favor of the Badgers. No one there to pick up Rodriguez.
Wisconsin with so much of that momentum because of what happened during the last set. Yeah, it was 25-17, but it didn't look that close as we got later. Nebraska had a push at the end. But when you put up 12 blocks in a single set, that'll kill any momentum that the other side has.
Tipped over by Riley on a pass that was too tight to the net.
Riley does such a great job identifying when this pass is too tight. She goes up as strong as she can to get those hands over. She knows it's a big block in front of her. She uses all the power she's got.
Two teams coming into tonight undefeated. 9-0 in conference, 18-0 on the season. No other team outside of the Citadel.
Go Bulldogs.
Is undefeated. Missed timing, but Smrek got enough on it to put it right in the middle.
It's tough to stop Anna Smrek. When you stand at 6'9 and you touch 11-2, even on some of these misconnections, you're still going straight up and over the blockers.
11-2. I mean, that is
unfathomable.
It's really remarkable. One of the great leapers in volleyball history as that swing is wide. Point for Wisconsin was Texas's Destiny Hooker, right? She was 6'3", 6'3 and a half. And she touched, I think, 11 feet, but not 11-2. That's...
Your wingspan feels like it's as big as the net. You're going to touch 11-2.
No touch, another point for the Badgers. And they're opening up this lead here in set number three.
We talk so much about the height of the seam, especially for a player like Anna Smrek, but it's not just height. She is as athletic as they come. And what she's done so well this season is being consistent with that. We've seen her up and down at times throughout the last few years. This season, it has been all go all the time.
On the slide. Again, hitting error for Nebraska over the top of the block and a timeout. Some of those courtside seats were
add a zero to that. They were expensive.
The people offering to carry my stuff in just so they could get into the game.
I saw that. Took it over on the second touch. Set over by Bergen.
This is where Nebraska needs to make some kind of adjustment. Over the last set and through this one, we've seen Nebraska take swings we haven't seen all season. They don't look like they're confident. They're just swinging high to try to avoid the block. They have to be a little bit more tactical in what they're doing offensively.
Killed by Smrek from that right pin.
Anna Smrek really coming alive as this game has gone on. Now, especially in this set, we're seeing her get a lot more balls her way. She's going up and over them. Nebraska doesn't have an answer.
Your X Factor coming in, right?
It is X Factor coming in. How well would she do and how well would Nebraska defend her? During set one, they were touching her up left and right. As the game has gone on, she's gotten better and better. You see those stats from the last season. I mean, she's elevated her play so much in the last year.
Just long on the serve. There is the 6'9 Anna Smrek. Dad played in the NBA, won two NBA titles with the Lakers. And she touches 11-2.
Just so athletic, even in the last few games, an incredible job managing her swing so well, even out of system.
I didn't ask her, but I wonder if she can dunk a basketball. She's got to be able to, right? There's Timmy Thomas-Ilara on that left pin.
It's tough to stop Wisconsin when they're in system. They have so many different weapons. On any given night, someone can go off. They have someone who's able to put the ball down. Temi Thomas-Ilara oftentimes can be that person for them.
Gutschtecken, back to serve. Run the middle, and there is Becca Alec.
Nebraska has to continue to get a player like Becca Alec going. It creates momentum for their team, and it's a sure attack. When she's up there, she's almost always one-on-one. She's winning those matchups.
Point for Wisconsin.
Allie Batenhorst reaching over the net, meaning that ball, it's not broken the plane. If she's reaching that far over to get it, that's illegal. You'll see this ball clear on Wisconsin's side. Oh, no. That looked like it was off Izzy Ashburn, who's in the back row. I see why Nebraska was not happy.
Ashburn touched it first. Blocks Robinson.
That'll create some momentum for the Huskers. Allie Batenhorst, she has a few of these stuffs every single game where she just gets her hands in the best position quickly and on these right side attacks. That's going straight down.
Franklin with just a little tip there right off the block and drops just on the Huskers side.
Franklin places her tip so well. It's going right almost down the back of the blockers. It's really difficult as a backcourt defender because you think the blocker might take it with their hands, but it just dribbles right down the back.
Hamill now to serve. And that is long. Good dive by Beeson. And the touch called on Wisconsin. And they're going to say they did not touch. And we might have a challenge here from Kelly Sheffield.
What a heads-up play by Bergen Riley sending this ball back to the corner.
I think he wants before he challenges. He wants to know what that call was. There was no touch there by the Badgers. And was it wide?
Definitely no touch.
I think they're, what it was the call that was in, or is it a touch? If it's they're calling a touch, I believe you're going to have a challenge.
The call, the line judge at least called that ball a touch.
Yep, and so Kelly Sheffield's going to challenge, and I think he's going to win this.
It's difficult to tell whether Orange will touch that ball or not. Smart challenge. It didn't look like Orange will touch it. If she says she didn't touch it, it's...
Well, clearly, they got the clarification from our R1 that who brought in the line judge. He said, no, I didn't call it was in. I called a touch. And that is out, right? And from the other angle, it looked like there was no touch by Ojol. But it would be...
And you can also...
Can you overturn it? Right.
I don't know, though, if you can definitively say that Orschel doesn't touch this ball, though, and it has to be clear evidence that there's no touch on it. And I guess none of her fingers move, but maybe if it touches a wrist, you might not see it. And I agree with you, that ball does look like it's out.
Yeah.
Which is also part of the challengeable play that they can look at.
Well, decision has been made. We'll see what the call is. There, I think you can see that she did not touch it up above.
Yeah, great angle.
Yep.
Bird's eye view.
It was out. Point Badgers. Good challenge.
But it is wide. Point Badgers. Checking in for the Badgers, number 12, Kemi Thomas Ilora. Back serving with 13.
Sarah Frankwood. Allie Batenhorst with the kill.
That's a big point for Allie Batenhorst. This is not a rotation that Nebraska wants to be stuck in. When you have Batenhorst up front with the setter up front in Andy Jackson, they need to get someone else up front like Harper Murray, who's your more terminal pin.
Lady Chilboy now back to serve. It's the rotation. Nebraska rattle off a few early in set number one. Ran the middle and delivered by Smrek.
Even with Nebraska's blockers fronting Smrek on these plays when the pass is good, she's still able to either cut inside, go right over it, hitting these shots beautifully around the block in front of her.
Harper Murray hasn't had a swing for a while. Sarah Franklin has out of the back row. She's dynamic.
Great connection between MJ Hamill.
They added 400 seats in the offseason to the Devaney Center, so they set an attendance record earlier this year against Ohio State. This breaks that record, 91-98. Joust at the net, won by Carter Booth. And it is all Badgers all the time right now. Wait, they're going to say Nebraska point. MJ Hamill wants clarification from our R1.
Let's take a look at this play. Carter Booth coming nearly down on the top of the tape, but it looked like it might have been the ball.
Yeah, I think if the Badgers would have challenged that, they might win that one too.
Also, when you're up six right now, maybe just not worth it.
That's right. Timmy Thomas Alara again into the block. Kept alive. Hamill gives the free ball over. And the block. No doubter by Smrek.
Timmy Thomas Alara just staying in this place, swing after swing. This is so tough as an outside hitter when you get these balls. Just throwing a little chicken wing at this. The fans here weren't that happy about that, but then at the end, Anna Smrek getting those hands dialed right back in. And she is dialed in.
Wow.
That was the last two sets.
One on one. Izzy Ashburn to serve. The tape on the slide. Alec, long, no touch. Badgers the first to 20 here in the third, and they are rolling up by eight.
Everything going well for Wisconsin. Offensively, they're able to put a ball down, find gaps in the block. Defensively, to shut Nebraska down. You also wonder how experience maybe plays into this. This is a Wisconsin team that has no freshmen on their court, really, ever, compared to Nebraska at any given time. You could have four freshmen on the court at one time. They haven't necessarily played in a number one versus number two, these big matchups. Yeah, they were tested during non-conference play, and they've played a few big conference games. You wonder how that might factor in.
Timmy Thomas-Ilara again with the kill. When you think of Timmy Thomas-Ilara, came from Northwestern, was their best player. Certainly you can make the case that Carter Booth was the best player from Minnesota. CeCe Crawford was the best player from Kansas. I mean, they are a collection of transfers. Sarah Franklin, the best player at Michigan State. They are a collection of some of the best players that have entered the portal and landed in Madison.
It helps when your youngest player on the court, Carter Booth, a sophomore, is one of the best in the country at both blocking and attack efficiency.
Yeah. Good bump set out to Franklin. Rolls it over from off the net. Run the middle into the block. Here's Beeson from outside the antenna. Wow, not sure how she got that kill. That was outside the antenna, went off the block, and still got the kill.
That's a veteran swing from Merritt Beeson, bettering that ball. Really bad set, trap set. It's outside the antenna, but she's able to adjust her body, adjust that arm swing to get it in. That's impressive.
It's one of those that if Franklin doesn't get her hands over, there's no way that stays in.
No chance. Impressive for Beeson to even get it in the court falling backwards and not just hit it straight at the antenna.
Izzy pushes out to Franklin. Right on the back line. What a shot by Sarah Franklin.
It's not always power from Sarah Franklin, which we know she can absolutely bring. It's her shot selection and placement that makes her so great. She attacks the edges of the court, dropping that one in right at the back line.
Beeson with a little heat, beat the block there, Crawford.
Beeson trying to get her team fired up. They need a lot more swings like that if they want to get back in this game. A beautiful set. She put a lot of juice behind that going right into the seam.
We're more animated than we've seen Beeson this year. She is trying to fire them up.
Beeson, the only player on this Nebraska team that has beat Wisconsin.
That's right.
She was at Florida last season at the Kohl Center.
Left it for Robinson. Swiped off the block, still alive. Good touch there by the Badgers. Back in system is Nebraska. Give it to Beeson again. An opportunity there with just Franklin up in front of her. Couldn't get it down. Good up by Rodriguez. Ojal keeps it alive. Robinson. The double. Nobody could believe there was a double there. Still alive. Beeson. Blocked it out.
Kudos for Nebraska staying in that rally. Entire Wisconsin bench and team furious about that missed double call, but Lexi Rodriguez, she doesn't care. She's stepping in, trying to make all of these plays. And another one. We got Bergen Riley this time laying out for the ball. And Beeson's able to put this down after a lot of back and forth.
Izzy Ashburn still talking to the R1. Kelly Sheffield was in the ear of the R2. And a yellow card.
Look, I think you're okay with that if you're,
yeah.
If you're Kelly Sheffield, if you're Izzy Ashburn. I mean, blatantly missed double call. Tell, even Harper Murray kind of let her head hang after that. She felt like it was double.
Ashburn not letting it go. They love that fire.
Yeah, you want someone that's going to fight for your team, whether it's your head coach or your captain.
Long rally point goes to Nebraska. Rodriguez to serve.
From here on out, Nebraska has to find a way to get the ball in the court, whether it's the end line or in attacking. They have to keep the ball in play, force the ball in Wisconsin, force them to try to make the errors.
MJ Hamill to serve. Great hustle by Murray. Good decision by Franklin, just not down. Back to Franklin again off the block.
Nebraska sends a free ball and then relies on that strong defense to shut down Wisconsin. A beautiful read on the outside, getting those hands in just in time from Jackson.
After tonight, both teams 9-0 in the league. Winner takes sole possession of first. And the middle off of Beeson and the kill. It's Crawford.
And that serves too easy for Nebraska. You put it right on Yulia Orgel. She's one of their best passers. She's going to nail that. That allows a middle attack to happen. It's an easy kill for Caroline Crawford.
Set point for the Badgers at 24-20. Batenhorst blocked on that right side, and Crawford again with the big block. In Wisconsin history, in fact, holds the record for all-time aces. Ran the middle. Bump set outside. Timmy Thomas, Ilara not down. One and up. Lady Choboy kept that alive. Timmy Thomas, Ilara again off the top of the block. And Beeson's swing is long.
A lot of out of system plays on both sides. You really have to dig in if you're an outside during long rallies, because a lot of out of system balls means you're getting a lot of junk. Wisconsin handling it really well. Temi Thomas-Ilara taking big swings.
Off the block and the kill by Robinson.
Robinson has such great court vision. She knows that Nebraska's taking away that line shot. She said, all right, cool. I'm going to rip it cross every single time then. And that's where she's getting her kills, either high hands cross court or right through the seam.
Just long. As Ashburn was targeting that back line, that in line, nearly had it. Back in for Nebraska is Batenhorst. Harper Murray back to serve. Go hard. service error. Five now on Nebraska.
That's a rotation for Wisconsin where you don't want to have the service error. They're only in a two-passer serve receive, so they have either Orgel back there and Sarah Franklin, because Temi Thomas-Ellar, they're shading. They don't want her to pass this ball. That's a serve where you got to put it in the court. There's a lot of seams to hit.
Gustakin serving. Bump set, Batenhorst. Tried line, no touch, point Badgers. And that block is just giving these Nebraska hitters a fit.
Nebraska's just trying to find ways around it. A lot of those are resulting in errors because Wisconsin is so disciplined, so pressed over, making it so hard for Nebraska to put a ball down.
Point Nebraska.
Just the third service error on the Badgers. Rodriguez now back to serve. Beeson gets the kill off the hands of Carter Booth.
Beeson's doing a phenomenal job adjusting to some of these sets. Not a great set for her. It's really pushed out past the pin. She adjusts her arm swing to it. She's able to get the kill. This has happened a few times now where that connection doesn't look good, but she's cleaned up a lot of that junk.
Off the tape. Ran the middle of Booth, no doubter, right at Rodriguez.
How about that set, Izzy Ashburn? That's a quick bang-bang play. Sometimes you don't expect the middle to get set because of how fast it is. That ball leaves her hand so quickly. She's almost sitting and still able to get Carter Booth the ball 6 feet off.
Beeson bails him out again. Another tough pass, but Beeson finds a way to put it away.
Beeson finding ways to score in difficult situations. Now with her in the backcourt, expect Bergen Riley to get her going on that D ball.
Down right on the line of the swing for Crawford.
Easy put down for Caroline Crawford. Only one blocker up in front of her, so she has both angles that she can hit. She just has to identify which angle that blocker is taking away. That's a big lane back to zone one.
Off the hands of Crawford with the kill.
Allie Batenhorst using power to get through that block. A little bit late, and she still finds a way to sneak it through, unloading that heavy arm.
If you're the Badgers, you don't want to let Nebraska hang around here at home. You've dominated sets two and three. You don't want this to go to a deciding fourth, and there is Jackson.
Nebraska gets momentum. This is what can happen. They're able to take over sets. Wisconsin has to nip this in the bud as soon as they can.
Swing was wide, right along the tape.
Joboy trying to get the fans pumped up, trying to use that momentum on their side. And you have 9,000 fans in here rooting for you. You've got to get them as hype as possible.
Tough serve.
All right, setter. Bergen Riley going up strong. The hang time there. To hold herself up there and on this ball, not a great connection. She just sees that and slaps it right back down.
Down, says Bergen Riley.
Not in Bergen's house.
Smack off the tape and out. 5-0 Nebraska run.
Just inside the line of the swing by Franklin. And what an angle that was. Thumb down.
It's one of the sharpest shots that we've seen all night. Harper Murray trying to dive out of the way. Let's take another look at this.
John Cook's going to challenge.
Is challenging the in call on the play.
As in.
Definitely looks in and not with those dodgeball skills though from Harper Murray with how fast that ball's coming.
When you get the overhead and the sideline look, you're going to see it caught that line right there. Yep. What a shot by Franklin. Just thumb down right on the line.
I mean, and in this freeze frame, look at Harper Murray. I mean, that position that she's in to make that happen. Right. My back hurts just looking at that.
It's Matrix stuff. Remember the movie, right? Matrix?
Matrix.
Yeah.
Come on.
Shouldn't have had to clarify it. I apologize. We need a few looks at it, apparently.
You know, Nebraska definitely thought that this ball was out, but this challenge also kind of stalls their momentum a little bit.
Yeah. Yeah.
The call on the court stands. Point, Wisconsin. Checking into the game for the Badgers, number 12, Timmy Thomas Ilara. Back serving number 13, Sarah
Franklin back to serve for the Badgers now. Slows that 5-0 run for the Huskers.
No question of whether she was going to get that kill with how much power she brought through it. This team's just finding ways to gain momentum in the little ways, and a lot of that is from power from Annie Jackson's arm.
Timmy Thomas Ilara from the left pin.
Thomas Ilara using her strength to get that kill, hitting it pretty flat, aiming right at that left back, about at the shoulder height. It's coming too fast to get your hands up on it, so it kind of just pegs her hands.
Left-handed swipe, Crawford is there. Back to Smrek, not down, but it is, perfect with the kill.
Good adjustment from Anna Smrek on this set. It was a bit lower than what she would have wanted. She sped up her approach and her arm swing to still get on top of that ball and put it straight down.
Trying to keep him in this. There's Beeson. Well off the net, delivers a kill.
Nebraska has to continue to force this ball on the right side of the court. Whether it's Merritt Beeson on that nine ball or bringing Annie Jackson on the side, it's been so successful against Wisconsin's left sides. They got to continue to get it going.
Tight to the net.
Over the net
called on Becca Alec.
Alec getting a little bit too aggressive on that ball, not on her side of the net. The ball breaks the plane, she's okay to go up and take it, but this time it's clear on Wisconsin's side as MJ Hamill's trying to go up and set it. Like Alec taking that chance away from her.
Serve from Ashburn. Back to serve now for the Huskers. Harper Murray on the slide. No touch. Deb Robinson wide.
That ball going out out of bounds, but this is what makes Wisconsin's offense so dynamic. A player like Devin Robinson, who normally is a right side attacker, they still run her on slide, so you have quick tempos all around. Mm.
The top of the block. And Banthorst puts it right back over.
Nebraska is starting to own the net up front. Their front line really coming alive, whether it's offensively or on these 50-50 balls, controlling the pace of play up front.
3-0 Nebraska run. Tough serve. Ashburn with the bump set out to Ilar. Dig by Rodriguez. Alec is in the way of the set of Riley. Murray steps in to take the second touch. And down. Point Badgers.
It's just a missed opportunity for Nebraska. Alexi Rodriguez with a jaw dropping up right on the money where Bergen Riley's supposed to be. Just getting in the way. Becca Alec stepping in front of her setter. But check out this dig. Coming with so much heat, she not only makes the play, gets it right on the setter. Just a miscommunication. Call. The ref thought that ball was in Allie Batenhorst's hand a little bit too long. Let's look at it again. Yeah. Looks like it hangs in her hand. It looks like she's kind of palming it for a sec. I agree with that. Vanny doesn't.
Straight up. Overpass. Franklin. Push back out. Franklin again. Got it. You know, there was a time when we didn't know if Sarah Franklin would be playing volleyball this year.
Such a great story from a player over the summer. They found blood clots in her right before the team went overseas. She's been back on the court. They didn't even know whether she was going to be able to play volleyball ever again, let alone step on the court this season in their first game back into that starting lineup. Just an incredible story for the outside attacker.
Husker is the first to 15. There's his son Chase next to him. Swing wide, point for Nebraska.
That's a good run for Wisconsin, getting Carter Booth going. Izzy Ashburn with a pretty good set. Booth's got to keep that one in.
Set out, Beeson down, running up by Ojal. Beeson again, tried line that time. Free ball opportunity here for Nebraska. From the go, back to Beeson again, into the block. Sarah Franklin with the big block.
Wisconsin's defense coming alive. Julia Orschel in the backcourt. Impressive plays just to keep this ball up. Her reaction time is second to none. A lot of these one-handers outside of her body. And then it's the front court. Sarah Franklin, static block move to put that one down.
The block and out. And another kill by Allie Batenhorst.
Much better swing from Allie Batenhorst up front, using the edges of the block, really testing them, getting that snap down just a little bit quicker at the fingertips.
Franklin with the pass right back to her. And as she's falling away and behind her goes down the net and gets the kill. What a shot by Franklin.
What a shot and what athleticism from her falling backwards. She's able to adjust that arm swing to nearly any set. Whether it's perfect or not, you just got to put it in the window for her and she'll figure out how to manage it and get a kill.
17-15 here in the fourth. Badgers trying to take this in four. Nebraska hoping to extend to a deciding fifth. Beeson from off the net. Ojo again with the up. Got the touch. And Wisconsin saying there was no touch, and Kelly Sheffield is going to challenge. So immediately after the swing, all the Badgers turned and said, no touch to the bench.
Kelly Sheffield, this is his only challenge remaining. Late in the fourth. You do get an additional one if this does go to a fifth set. You got to be pretty sure about this. Didn't look like a touch by Smrek up front.
This would be a good look. Nope.
Yeah, clear over.
No fingers. No. This will be overturned. Good look from our camera crew.
I mean, that's an absolute wall up there. The only thing you can do in this situation is hit right down into it or out of bounds.
You get looks like that thanks to our director, Pat O'Connor, right?
Good job, Pat.
After further review, the ball is reversed. The hit is wrong. Point, Badger.
17-16. Up, Hamill with the dive. Back out. Misconnection between Bergen Riley and Allie Batenhorst, and we're knotted at 17.
Nebraska trying to run their offense, but Wisconsin's defense making that difficult, and a missed opportunity as Caroline Crawford goes up with the setter. Outside is one-on-one, just the timing.
In all three of those categories. On the slide, no touch. Point for Wisconsin, and they have the lead.
Another misconnect on Nebraska's side. A good decision to get that slide going. The ball just not exactly where Andy Jackson wanted it in the window.
4-0 Badger run. Huskers had the lead at 17-14. There is Beeson out of the back row. The pick for Beeson.
Nebraska's got to get Beeson going, whether she's in the front or the back. She has been terminal for them, finding the windows to hit, putting it right through. On this ball, when she's in the back row, sometimes she has a better lane to hit. She can see the blockers better, so she knows exactly what shot to take.
Laney Choboy will serve. Franklin off the top of the block. Great shot there by Franklin. Took a little off at high hands. Got the kill.
Doesn't always have to be the hard swing. Sometimes these balls have just the same effect when you're going at fingertips. Doesn't have to be that hard. Just aim right for them and it'll go straight off. Such a crafty attacker.
Swing is wide, hitting error on Nebraska. Point Badgers, and they're now on a 6-1 run. First to 20, trying to close it out here on the road in the fourth and pick up their 11th consecutive win over Nebraska. Thomas Ailara with a kill.
How about that shot? Everything about it. Temi Thomas Ailara showed you she was going to hit cross court.
One run as Wisconsin tried to close this out here in set number four. Second touch and down. That time the dump, not the set over. With things that Bergen Riley is really working on is that one-handed dump.
Really smart decision in time to do so as well. She hasn't been offensive all night. That was a perfect opportunity. Tight ball, no blocker up. She can put it straight down.
Kennedy Orr. And Allen called once again. Nope. It's going to be back row attack called on the Badgers.
Better decision from Becca Alec this time, not being too aggressive, but identifying that ball is over so she can be as aggressive as she wants.
Kelly Sheffield looked down. Tough serve, and Orr with the ace.
From your serving stuff, stepping into the game, all the pressure is on you. Your backs are against the wall. This is a must-win point. Kennedy Orr steps in and puts in a bullet.
21-21. Two players in the background, Rowan with the Orr for Orr's serve. They're right back to Franklin after the pass. Good hustle by Riley. Showboy steps in to take second touch. Not down. Well, the crowd thought it was over the antenna, so did we. And the block by Wisconsin. Boy, did that look like that was over the antenna.
I kind of thought it was inside. It looked a little clean to me. That block just doing work up front. Let's get another look at this. Smrek tries to take that ball over.
Yep, he's going to challenge. So the challenge is, was it inside or outside the antenna?
Seeing it live, I thought it was inside.
That there was an out call on the play.
Be tough to tell with this angle. If that was over the top of the antenna, outside the antenna. Right. I think that was inside.
It was inside.
Yep.
Especially with the ref right there and the antenna in front of him.
There
you
can go.
See whether the antenna was in between or not.
There's the look.
Yep. That's inside. I mean, based on the reaction, though, of the crowd and everyone, yeah. John Cook, you kind of have to challenge that.
So we believe this one will stand, and the Badgers will be up 20. And there's the knuckles, which Sheffield is
always
famous for. See what the call was. It stands, point for the Badgers. CC Crawford now to serve. 22-21, big moments here in set number four. Outside. Free ball over after the swing from Murray. Back to Murray again. Just did not get on top of that. And it's a hitting error in a crucial moment for Nebraska.
In these moments when Nebraska's back is against the wall, they have to rely on one of their veteran players. For this team, that's Mara Beeson. She's in the back row, but you get her going on a pass.
Tough serve by Crawford. Beeson from all the way around the back out of the back row gets the kill.
Mara Beeson wants to put the team on her back. Set her every ball. I don't care. Just keep feeding her. She wants the ball in these big moments. She's proved she can put the ball down in these big moments. You've got to feed her.
Going to swing all the way around. Take off from beyond that 10-foot line and get the kill. Bergen Riley. Franklin. No touch, sir. Smrek with the swing. Did not get on. What a rare hitting errors for. Tough serve by Beeson, or by Riley. Off the block it out, point for the Badgers, and now we have match point upcoming for Wisconsin. And to serve is one of the best servers for the Badgers, Izzy Ashburn. If there's anyone you'd rather have at the line. Match point. Just inside the end line, tied at 24.
Harper Murray with one of the biggest swings of her career so far. She's been playing in a hole this entire game, was hitting negative before this, but they still trust her in these big moments because she's been a go-to attacker for them all season long.
Little tip by Riley. Into the net called on the Badgers. And now we have set point for the Huskers. Tough serve. At times on both sides, and now a race to 15 in the fifth. Izzy Ashburn leads it off. Timmy Thomas Ilari gets a kill.
Thomas Ilari using that power to go right through the block. Becca Alec almost thought that she had that one in the right position to make the play. Thomas Ilari just bringing too much with it.
Eight kills for Thomas Ilara. Tough serve by Ashburn. Choboy handled it well. Outside Murray. What a swing by Harper Murray. Deep corner.
Harper Murray starting to rise to the occasion more and more. She's still hitting in the negatives, but as this game has gone on, especially late in that fourth, now into the fifth, they trust her in these moments because now she's feeling a little bit more confident, knowing that she can do it.
And now she's at the service line where she ended set number four but has struggled so many times throughout the year. And another tough serve. Thomas Ilara got that back line.
Good fend off from Sarah Franklin on that pass. That was a bullet coming from Murray on the end line. Thomas Ilara switching up her shot, going right to that corner. Check out that pass, so difficult to defend. Not only gets it up, but puts Izzy Ashburn in a good position.
Good chicken to serve. And Beeson's swing is wide.
In this fifth set, every point feels like it has the weight of about 3 points because you only play to 15, so those errors sometimes can just haunt you. The key in the fifth set is being low error but staying aggressive.
Huge to Ken again. Just long. Boy, that was close. Jackson back in for Nebraska. Rodriguez back to serve. Rodriguez, Peyton Horst.
good dig back row. And it falls on Nebraska's side. Point Badgers.
And the defense in this is exactly what you want in a fifth set. All out from both sides. Balls that you do not think have any reason being up. Orgel diving out for one. Lexi Rodriguez, incredible up. Gigi, how about that? Bend in half.
Andy Jackson. And that quick one.
Not to say Nebraska hasn't used too often tonight, because they're trying to go away from those middles, especially someone like Anna Smrek when she's up front. But this was a good decision to run it. When you have that quick outside, an overload situation, really test those blockers.
Franklin from that left pin. She has 16 kills in the match.
Sarah Franklin's just money for this team. I mean, you put the ball within about 3 feet and she finds a way to get a kill in crafty ways. Not always the hard shot, oftentimes going for those high hands. Right to that opposite back corner, because you're oftentimes splitting the defenders in the backcourt.
12 kills for Batenhorst. That is a season high. Deep breath for Lainey Choboy. Into the net, called on Nebraska. Badgers have maintained right around that two-point lead, have not trailed here.
Back serving number 13, Sarah Franklin.
Up against Merritt Beeson in the backcourt. She can find that lane to hit, and if you give her that much space, she's able to go around it.
Good hustle by Hamill to keep that alive. Timmy Thomas Alara right into the block. Go the other side, Deb Robinson. Murray off the block to the kill by Harper Murray. What a fist pump from John Cook off the bench.
Harper Murray elevating her play in this fifth set. We're finding out a lot about this freshman outside in these big moments. She lives up to it.
As animated as I've seen Coach Cook in a while, he was nearly out to the court with the big fist bump. 6-6. And Orr serve is long. That was our first tie since it was 1-1. Badgers now lead it by one. Crawford now back to serve for the Badgers. Short serve, Choboy got to it. Beeson runs that again, good up by CeCe. Out to the pin, and TT delivers. Yeah, TT and CeCe stepping up big. And they're the first to eight, and they'll switch sides at eight.
This is what makes this offense so tough to stop. It's coming from everywhere. It's not just one person.
8-6, Crawford to serve. Harper Murray blocked. Right back to her again, pulled inside. Murray got the kill.
What a gutsy swing from the freshman. Doesn't get the first one, comes right back, but she continues to take swing after swing. You have to stay aggressive in a fifth set. Tips are not going to win this ball game.
Bergen Riley will now serve for Nebraska. Down 8-7. Good pass by Franklin. Robinson off the top of the block, and Devin Robinson picks up her 10th kill of the match.
That'll send Anna Smrek back into the game, one of Wisconsin's most physical blockers up front. This is their best rotation with Booth up front, 6-7. Anna Smrek, 6-9. Trying to be aggressive from the service line, having difficulty though, keeping it in.
The service long point.
Back-to-back service errors.
Checking in the serve for Wisconsin, number 21.
All right, now we're entering the red zone of the fifth set here. Wisconsin's already to 10 points. Nebraska back against the wall, you're down two. You gotta keep the ball in play, both offensively and from the end line. Keep it in, rely on that defense. Both teams have done such a great job of it tonight.
Gooch Tekin to serve. Here's Beeson from off the net. Got the roll, went inside the block of Carter Booth and got it to fall.
Not the perfect set for Merritt Beeson, but she bettered that ball. She adjusted to it, swung her arm a little bit faster inside. It's behind her head, and she still finds that power to swing through.
Second match this season with 20 kills for Merritt Beeson. Tough there. And bailing them out is Smrek.
That's what Anna Smrek does when she's up front. Just a thunderous swing.
Versus two matchup in Lincoln, Nebraska. 11-9. Badgers on top. Ozel to serve. Beeson. Good up. Just Jackson got a fingertip on it. Back to Beeson again. 21 kills for Merritt Beeson.
Coming into this game, Merritt Beeson knew she had to be big against a smaller block on that side. She had to go off if she wanted this Nebraska team to find success. She is elevating her play as this game has gone on. She's putting the Huskers on her back.
Two service errors here in a critical set five for the Huskers. Hamill back in to serve now for the Badgers. Three away from the match. Nebraska siding out at 60%. Desperately needs a side out here. Horse, good dig into the net card on Wisconsin.
In this fifth set, a lot of errors piling up on both sides, whether it's service errors we've seen in the net just a few times. Both teams have to play a little bit cleaner. Just coming down off the block. Caroline Crawford gets that elbow.
Joe Boys serve. Franklin from off the net. Rodriguez with the dig. Murray, roll shot. Who steps up big here late? Deb Robinson off the block. Out of system, it goes to Murray.
This fits. set, Harper Murray had been hitting negative, and she has not looked back since. She has been lights out from the end of the fourth into this fifth set in every facet of her game, both offensively from the end line, defensively stepping up big as a freshman.
Badgers had a match point. Here's Nebraska's match point. Not yet, 13, there we go. Now match point upcoming. And here it is, match point for Nebraska. Not yet, says Sarah Franklin.
Late in sets, Franklin becomes that ghost.
Match point number two for Nebraska. So often these don't live up to the billing. This has lived up to every bit of it. Franklin to serve. Murray did not get on top, and we've got extra points in a one versus two. This might be a settle down challenge here, right? You're late.
Nebraska is challenging.
I thought that was well over the block. They're going to say net violation. Thought maybe there was a net violation. Check it.
Question of whether this was a net violation if Wisconsin came down on it.
Oh. So was the ball out before the net?
No.
Okay.
No.
Well, this would be a strange way to end it, right? Our R2 down below to make a call that could have this crowd erupt. Decision coming from Joseph Gustafson.